and some key plays on special teams. Let's see if they can get that second win in a row.
On the other side of the field for the visiting 49ers, they've got to be pleased with the start to this season, obviously. A perfect 3-0.
Three good quality wins, too. It's got people to win, and that's what they did last week. But there's also plenty for him to work on in his game, wasn't there?
Yeah.
Two touchdowns, an interception. Yeah, you know, he wants to increase that a little bit in terms of ratio. But first and foremost, they did win the game.
First carry for James Conner. And he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled. Gotta like that start. 14 yards to get him going. He was solid last week, over 100 yards in their victory on the ground. They want to get that going again.
Absolutely. What they also understand is that from week to week, it's not necessarily the same, but they want it to be, right? What they saw last week on the ground, they want to see in this game as well.
Throwing on first down is Murray. He'll dump this one off to Conner. And they get to him after a gain of 6 to the 46. The Cardinals hit. To throw again on second down. Murray, he's going to look deep for more. And that will be incomplete. Tried to dial up the long one way out there, but it'll be third down. Here's Murray. And this is going to be incomplete.
Not quite sure.
Quarterback.
I like this guy. And the reason I do, he tends to stay on an even keel. Doesn't let too much ruffle him. He will manage the game the way it needs to be managed, take what the defense gives him, and then he can strike at times. Had a touchdown pass. Yes, yes.
Feet short on third and three. Leaves him with a fourth and one.
So many things going to making a good play on defense. In this situation, just not being blown out of the way was a big start, and then a nice tackle to finish things off.
Early on, you know, Charles, every game could be called a measuring stick game, but I think when it comes within your division like this, it's a measuring stick game with a little extra intrigue.
I would agree with that totally, because all division games have a little extra to them, being somewhere in that neighborhood.
And he goes out right around the 39. That one will go for 9 yards and a first down on the keeper.
So that was all you're looking for on a play like that, get the first down and keep the drive moving.
To throw is Murray. Quick hitter here, it's complete. And he'll be out of bounds up near the 45 at the 44. It'll be a gain of 5.
They're just quicker than fast. A lot of them combine quickness and speed, and they catch a lot of footballs, as we just saw there.
Dancing to his left. Looking left side, it's complete. He's got it. And this will move the chains again as the tackle's going to be made at the 49ers' 44-yard line. Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another first down.
That's the third that's on the planet. You talk about guys, if they weren't playing football, they'd be starring in the NBA at power forward. It's a really difficult task.
A second down pass play there, but it's incomplete.
Against a team coming off a win. Just
Murray now. He'll get this complete to Rondale Moore. And this will move the chains again as the tackle's going to be made at the 49ers' 22-yard line. That's a third down conversion of 24 yards there. Nice play.
And time to get some credit to the offensive line here, because you've got that good protection on crossing routes, because you've got to give your receiver.
On first and 10 is Conner. And some determined running there as he'll pick his way down to the 12-yard line. They get 10 more there, and I believe that'll be enough for another first down. It will. The first drive this unit had, they punted. This drive, much more polished, just looking crisper, aren't they, moving the ball. Murray going to throw. Screen pass to Conner. And he takes it inside the 10 to the 8 before he's out of bounds. They'll get four there out of the screen, and it's second down. Good on the jet sweep. The 6 yards on the pickup, and it leaves them with a first and goal.
Well, we've seen running backs in today's NFL get involved in the passing game. Maybe it's about time more receivers like that get involved.
Now Anderson on the jet sweep. The 6 yards on the pickup, and it leaves them with a first and goal.
Well, we've seen running backs in today's NFL get involved in the passing game. Maybe it's about time more receivers like that get involved in the running game.
And that is something we are seeing more and more in this league, no question about it. That wasn't the biggest of gains, but it was enough to get a
counter. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
This defense is a difficult one to prepare for, one of the best in the league. They'll come at you from all angles, and they did a nice job.
Checked up to the 3 yard line, second and goal. Ooh. To throw, it's Murray. He's got his man. It's caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Arizona. Rondale Moore, his third touchdown now on the year.
And the Cardinals will jump on top of the game's first score.
Your team, a lot of them say, we're going to build from the inside out, because if you control the line of scrimmage, you control the rest of the ball game, and that's what we're seeing here. They're actually playing in the offense's backfield, not necessarily just playing at the line of scrimmage.
That's a good job there, creating the contact.
And now, since it's fourth down, that should set up a field goal situation.
And a nice sigh of relief defensively to be able to hold them to three. And his kick is good. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3.
Feels like they're calling this game in reverse. Normally you run to set up the pass. Here it feels like they're passing, hoping to set up the run and be more effective later on in the game.
Yeah, you can do it both ways. We usually talk about it in the reverse, however.
No doubt about it.
Run, so the offense is going to go back to huddle, feel pretty good about themselves. Defensively, you have to feel okay because you didn't let it turn into a bigger run. But the goal, shut it down for 2 yards or less. That's when you start to feel good about yourselves.
Tackles, because we ask them to just eat up blocks and allow other people to make tackles. But when he can make a play himself, as we just saw there, that's a big day.
And this is going to be a Cardinals first down as he'll take this up to the 38-yard line.
That's about what you would expect since they're so efficient on picking up third downs in the top five in the NFL. It's all a mindset, and I guarantee you, it started in the offseason.
Third and 10 at the 38. And now Murray's going to set up to throw. They'll roll him out right. And he finds a man with a crossing route. And he has a big gain inside the 40 before being dropped. 23 yards, the final tally.
Looked like the defense put pretty good pressure on him, but he's able to flush out to his right.
So from inside Niner territory now, this is first and 10 at the 39-yard line. They'll go option to the short side. Add the gain here to the previous play, and it's better than 40 yards total.
I tell you, there is no antidote for speed, even at the quarterback position, as he keeps it himself and turns it into good yardage.
And it still takes time for a defender to react.
10, 12 yards downfield at that point.
Murray a give. This is Connor.
Credit him with a 1 yard gain there to make it second and 9.
A 1 yard gain could look like a disaster, but it all depends on how they get one. Come back and get him the next time.
Connor going to get it again on second down.
And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. A yard in the wrong direction makes third down tougher. Third down and 9.
Right off the snap to get into the backfield and make that play.
Here's Murray as he sets to throw it. Able to get this one to McBride. He's got the first down and more. Touchdown! Trey McBride. His first touchdown on the year. And they're able to add on to their advantage.
On that third down call, the goal was to get the ball to their tight end and pick up a first down, but he wasn't satisfied with it.
Diagnosed as perfect on that one. Read his keys, made the play, and he couldn't even get going moving the football.
And they're going to mark him down short, maybe by about a yard, if that. That'll go for a gain of 7 before. On fourth down, Kyle Shanahan will send out the field goal unit. Made his first, this now from 42 yards out. And this one is right through. And a second field goal here cuts their deficit to 14-6 now.
Sometimes it's just way more important to have the points on the board than to worry about any type of a gamble.
Here's James Conner now as he trots back onto the field. He's been good. His guys are winning. So far, the recipe working here in the second quarter.
And he doesn't like to just...
First down, Murray. Very quickly here, and that's complete. He'll be dropped after a gain of about 6 across the 30 to the 31.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver and strike. Good head of steam going.
On second down, Conner looking for space. And he's able to tap this one to the 4 yards, they pick up that first down. We'll have stats and scores from around the NFL. You and Jonathan Coachman both larger than life.
No doubt about it.
But you're stuck with me in this booth.
Yes,
and he's miles away and smiling.
And happy.
Now this one complete downfield on the left side. And they'll get this down to around the 47-yard line.
Well, this is an awfully tough route to defend in man coverage because he lines up on the right and runs a crossing route back to the other side of the field. So as a defender, you're not only trailing him the whole way, you also
Murray now on first down. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And he's going to be marked down just inside the 35. And a good quarterback facing zone cover.
Go to a zone blitz scheme, get a little bit more pressure. Remember when Carolina did that against Denver? They lost the game ultimately. They dropped the defensive end out, and he ended up with an interception in that game in Super Bowl 50. Maybe some sort of scheme like that to try and get more pressure.
This is taken in by McBride. And this will move the chains again as the tackle's going to be made at the 49ers 16. The Cardinal passing game dialed in now. First 16 here for first and 10. Murray now to throw. Toward the back corner of the end zone, but he could not get the feet down. This will wind up incomplete.
I see the surprise.
This offense was on the move. Now two straight incompletions have him looking at third and 10. Now here's a look for the end zone, but that one's going to wind up incomplete.
What an excellent defensive stand there in the red. Nice tight coverage. They certainly recognized how important it was to bring up fourth down here.
McCann's kick is good. And that will extend their lead here to 17-6. They'll keep it on the ground again here. And this will go as a short gain on what will. A
whole lot to write home about so far. Meanwhile, for the Cardinals, you get a look at what they were able to do throwing the football. And whatever they've done, it's worked, as they have the lead through two quarters of play. Both teams finishing up their halftime.
We are 3-1 in the Super Bowl.
Offensively, virtually nothing in the ground attack either. So certainly something has to change here in quarter three.
And I'm pretty sure their friends from the defensive side of the ball told them exactly that, because those guys, the stop troops, they've been playing pretty well. They've kept them around in this game. Now they got some time. The running game struggled in the first half. Opposition knows how to focus on defending the pass here. They've got to re-energize that ground game and maybe open things up for a comeback here in this half.
They'll set up a throw. And incomplete on the deep ball.
You get the sense that they're saying, we're not playing up to what we're capable of.
First and 10. They begin on the ground here with Conner. Oh, he's got some breathing room. And getting this just shy of midfield, spotted at the 49. 59 yards rushing for him now on what was his 10th carry of the ball game. I don't know what this says about me, but I love successful runs up the middle when the blocking is so well executed like that.
And it does sometimes a thing of beauty.
Throwing on first down is Murray. Wide open receiver complete. And they're able to work this to the 25 before it's all said and done. The 26 big yards on that one. It's another first down.
Now we get into the psychology of the whole thing, because a lot of teams with a two-score lead in the third quarter, visit it, but he's more than that. This guy is nimble and quick, more than a space eater. He just made a great play there.
Over the middle, complete. That's Connor. That he's brought down, but he has it down to the 12 on a pickup of 12, first and 10.
He certainly had success throughout this contest, getting him the ball in the passing game, and there he picks up another first down. Whatever they saw going
down at the 12, it's first and 10. Now Murray. And he couldn't quite get there. Tackled down at the line. Nothing open downfield. He keeps it himself for 11 and a first down.
Fast, slow, it doesn't matter. If you give a quarterback enough room to escape, it's like the game's on the line. It's just a third quarter, but another touchdown given up here could really spell an end to their chances, so they need to toughen up and keep them out of the end zone.
Once again, it's Connor, and he is in for six. Touchdown, Cardinals. James Connor with his sixth rushing touchdown on the year, as his guys are able to push that lead out a bit further. Everybody in the stadium knew what they were going to do right there, CD. Three tight ends on the field, all that extra bulk, and they run it in.
And you saw where that one went, right? You run it over your best blocker. I can just see the head coach right now. I want to run this one over the big boy. And they got it done.
It's McCaffrey. And they've got this down to about the 12-yard line.
Always important as a defender on third down to keep the play in front of you and make sure you don't give up enough space that they can make a move on you in the open field. Try as he might.
On fourth down, Kyle Shanahan will send out the field goal unit from the right hash, and this one just a chipping. And his kick is right there. It's good. So he's been automatic to this point.
Let him going again.
And now the third down throw incomplete as well. I don't know, he had to be pretty quick with his fingers to start and stop after the ball hit the ground. I'm giving him some. He'll get this underneath to McCaffrey, and he'll be stopped at the 27-yard line, well short of the first down marker. 3 yards all they could muster there, and it'll bring up fourth down.
How about that? So every time I hear fans telling me tackling's not a part of the game anymore, plays like that, I can clip and save and show them you have to tackle well if you want to be a good defense.
So the response to that touchdown on the other side, these guys definitely hoping for a better showing than their last appearance. They couldn't really even move the football much beyond the shadows of their own goalpost, Charles. We'll see if they can get a better, more sustained drive going here.
Yeah, and every team that we ever talk to says the exact same thing when you start.
They've hit at 50%, 3 of 6 to this point. They need just a yard here. It's third and one. They'll try and run for it with Connor. They get 9 yards there, and they get a first down. At carries like that, that's how they're going to continue to salt this thing away here, Charles, in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, how about that? A new set of downs. Clock continues to move. No better way to close out a game than to tap those mastodons.
Just not enough time for the play to develop. Just lucky it wasn't a fumble, really. From the gun on third down, Murray. Quick hitter here. It's complete. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. First target, first catch, and first down.
And that pickup of a first down, that's going to leave a mark because they really needed to stop them there, didn't they?
So frustrating. Defensively, you're a play away from getting that football back here. Oh, there's that man again. It's complete. And they'll get this down to around the 47-yard line.
I always laugh when people say, what's the toughest route to defend? And I'm like, any of them, especially.
From the gun, again to Connor. And he's dropped just before the line to gain. 4-yard pickup leaves him with third and one.
Brandon, I've got to think this offensive line has got some smile. They're up to the challenge.
On third down, it's Connor. And he will be very close to a first down, but I see the closed fist of the referee, and that means fourth down. This late in the game, Charles, I think you maybe... And that means fourth down. This late in the game, Charles, I think you maybe seriously have to think about going for it.
What do you guys think? Long field goal or go for it?
This is almost like no
Which one?
Might hurt your punter because there might not be enough space. Maybe to him.
They're going for it. It's Murray. And intercepted. Maybe the turning point they need. Picked up by Talanoa Hufanga to the 32. They'll come to the line, needing only 2 yards to gain the first here. Slipped one tackle, but no more as he's knocked to the deck behind the line of scrimmage. He lost two, and it brings up four.
I like the idea to mix it up from time to time because, let's face it, you can't be predictable. But the execution was a little lacking on this one, right? They might want to go back to the drawing board with that.
Got to try it here. He's back to throw. And able to haul it in is Kittle. And he is going to have the Niners first down as they manage to convert. And that'll keep the drive alive. The time to pull out the stops is now. And that'll pick up of 2 yards. They'll be in search of 8 yards here as they hope to convert the first down. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. Pressure comes and the Cardinals bring him down. Finally hauled down for the first time this game. Multiple defenders in there to drop him.
And you hate to say it with a rookie quarterback. He's done some good things, but overall, looked a little bit overwhelmed back there, hasn't he?
He certainly has. But in his defense, he hasn't had a lot.
As expected, they're going for it to keep the drive alive. Lines up and lets it go for Samuel. And he's going to take this one back to the 37-yard line.
There he is out there ball hawking, hoping that should finish the game.
First and 10 at their own 37. He'll start the drive with a give to Connor, and he'll take this ahead for about 4. Second down coming up. Gotta figure now, after getting that turnover, they're just gonna be happy to keep the ball on the ground.
Offense right now, just take care of it, and they've got a good chance of ending up winning this game.
Connor gonna get it again on second down, and very little daylight there. He'll get a couple up to the 44.
And this is an absolutely big third down that's been set up here.
And they'll run the option on third and short yardage.
Well, that didn't work.
2 minute break. We'll get a timeout used defensively with a minute 50. 16-10 at the 11. Back to throw again. Back to deep. Now the ball comes loose. And the Cardinals have got it. Going the other way.
Oh, this is a good way to end it. Come get me, Hackett.
Unit in the league, and they pretty much had their way.
Yeah, that was the interesting part about it, because normally when we see this defense play, they have their opportunities and they make their plays, don't they?